When we first won the design competition, we were almost thinking, oh wow, we're actually going to have to build it. So at this point, it was our software tool set, Archicad, but also Grasshopper, which enabled us to create scripts that we could use. For example, here, to limit the curvature and the waviness, trying different variations. The way the Grasshopper software works is you create functional building blocks, which are completely parametric. In other words, we can start with a given shape modeled in Rhino. Then we assign scripts that transform these components, distribute, multiply, reshape, and so on. And then we connect them to Archicad objects with a live connection. This way, a Rhino point can become a column or a beam. A contour in Rhino can become a slab or anything you want. And from this point on, thanks to Grasshopper's parametric capability, we have full freedom to change the parameters around and see how they affect the generated shape.
Parametric de Grasshopper de faire varier ces paramètres pour voir leur incidence sur la forme produite.
The important thing about all this software is that we use it in the service of design, in the service of architecture. Let's face it, when the client first sees the initial sketches of this Montpellier project, they might be a little shocked. Can this even be done on a tight budget? But the whole purpose of the parametric design process was to try to use the right material in the right place and then adjust to it. For example, we analyzed the metal meshes, played around with the parameters to try to limit the amount of tubing. For example, we tried making them looser, tighter, changing their diameter, maybe 70 millimeters, how about 90 millimeters, to try different variations, then pick a solution that is economically reasonable. Also, these adjustments were happening not just during the design phase, but also during construction while communicating with the contractor. So we had to consider how these changes would be implemented, how much work would be involved, which also had budget implications. And we were able to solve it with the help of parametric design. The 3D model in Archicad allowed us to see how the design was evolving and to make sure we were staying true to the sketch we started with. For the Higher Roch project, this software has been absolute key. So we have this software that allows for a huge degree of design freedom. But at the same time, we can guarantee that it provides accurate quantities and objective data about the project. This reassures our customers, which is of course absolutely fundamental, and it's the flip side to the tremendous degree of freedom which inspires our designs. A project is a dialogue. It's an exchange. Most of all, it requires really understanding the client who comes to us, because architecture is essentially art that we have been commissioned to do. So if we look at it this way, it's crucial that we know how to hear and how to listen, and then how to render and translate what they're asking for. In this process of rendering and translation, there are so many different possibilities. And this is where Archicad is a pretty nice tool. It lets us start out from a geometric basis that we can quantify at any time. We can extract all the quantitative aspects of this project. The design possibilities are endless. We could do it this way, or that way, or that way, but also maybe this way, and also this way. And with all these this way and that way, the project owners are simply delighted. And then, when that possibility of like this becomes a reality like this, and we actually deliver like this, what we have is pure happiness.
Le bonheur absolu.